Hi, I'm Ursula Sadiq with Autodesk Plant Solutions. In this video, we will introduce you to some new features in AutoCAD Plant 3D 2011. First, we'll explore the new file naming template option, and then how to convert a line to pipe. Then we'll cover other new pipe routing features including line locking, precise part placement, inserting components as you route, and adding sloped pipe. There are two other notable new features in this release that I'd like to mention: adding annotations to orthographic drawings, and viewing objects in Navisworks. We'll talk about those features in other videos in this series. In AutoCAD Plant 3D 2011, you can create new drawings from the Project Manager, and the dialog will let you name this file any legal Windows file name. Here you can see how I have a drawing called Pipe 1. Now I will show you how to create a template for naming these files. First, I get into Project Setup, which I do by clicking Project Manager in the ribbon and selecting Project Setup. Under the General Settings in the tree, there is a node named File Name Format. I am going to create a format with four parts: Unit-Area-Type, and then a number. So I'm going to end up hitting this Add button four times, and each time naming the subpart of the template. Here I'm going to enter Sequence for my sequence number. All right, there I have it: Unit, Area, Type, and then a sequence number. I can also set the type of the sequence to be numerical, and I can set the exact length I want in each of these subparts. And lastly, I'm going to remove this trailing delimiter because I don't want the dash at the end of my file name. I'm going to hit Apply to save and OK to get out of Project Setup. OK, now back in Plant 3D, I will create a new drawing. Notice how now we have a template: Unit, Area, Type, and then Sequence, which you can fill out to name your drawing. Once the drawing is named, you can press OK to close the dialog and create the drawing. I'm going to create another drawing using the same dialog, but this time I'm going to check the Override button. Checking this button allows me to go back to freeform naming of the file. There we go, Pipe 1A, hit OK. Now I have a Pipe 1A file in my project tree. Finally, I'm going to show you what happens when I try to enter either too many digits or the wrong type of characters in one of these fields. Unit, as you remember, was a string. A string can either be numbers or letters, but I only picked two characters for this template. So when I put in three, I get an error. Same thing with area. It can only be two characters, whether those are letters or numbers. Any more and I get an error message. All right, sequence is the same way, but sequence I made numerical, so any letters will give me an error message, even if it's four. So again, four numbers is fine. Five with the A on the end, I'll get an error message. And whenever I'm in this error condition, the OK button is grayed out, so I cannot create the file. All right, there you have it: a quick introduction to the file naming template feature, new in AutoCAD Plant 3D 2011. Next, we'll explore how you can use the line to pipe feature to convert an AutoCAD line to Plant 3D piping. Here I am drawing a regular AutoCAD line just using my AutoCAD line command. I'll stop the line here, and I'll use a midpoint snap to draw a line from the middle of one of these sections to make a little bit more interesting route. And then I'll select all these lines. I look at my ribbon, my size is 8 inches, my spec is CS150. I'm going to select the line to pipe option. Wait a moment, and there you go, the line is converted to pipe. You can see that the T is put at the intersection where I branched, and also the elbows follow the 90 degree bends. I did this with AutoCAD lines, but you could have done this with polylines or arcs. All right, there you go. A quick introduction to the new line-to-pipe feature in AutoCAD Plant 3D 2011. Next up, line locking. I have three lines here, the green line, the red line, and those other two colors are the same line. I'm going to open Data Manager and see that I have three pipelines. I'm going to go ahead and lock the first one by right-clicking and picking Locked Line from the context menu. You can see how Data Manager now reports back that a particular line is locked. What does a line being locked mean? Well, it means you can't move it, you can't erase it, and you can't edit it. So here, back in the graphics window, I'm hovering over one of the locked line pieces, and you see I get a tooltip that says line is locked. For comparison, here's a tooltip of an unlocked line. Now, if I try and select the line to move or erase it, you'll notice the line will highlight, but I don't get any grips. It's hard to show in the video, but I'm clicking and I'm not able to grab this line and move it. And finally, what happens if I try to route from an existing line to this locked line? I will come over and do a near snap to try and branch into this pipe, and I get an error message saying, "The destination line number is locked. You can only connect to existing open ports on a locked line number." There's some more details in this error message on how to unlock a line from either Data Manager or the ISO tab in Project Manager. So there you go, the new locked line feature. If you think about it, you can see how you can use this feature to block out edits of any lines that perhaps already been issued for construction or that have already been reviewed and should not change anymore. I'm sure you can think of a number of ways on how this feature would be useful in your real-world projects. Now let's move on to precise part placement. I'll show you how to precisely place a part into an existing pipeline. I'm going to pick a part from my tool palette, in this case a flange gate valve, and notice how I drag along my existing pipe, I get dynamic dimensions, indicating where I've located this part. I can also change the insertion point from where I'm placing this part. I change the insertion point by entering I, and notice how it changes to the far side of the valve, the midpoint, and then back again to the original insertion point. Now I can tap into one of these dynamic dimensions and enter a precise value, such as 10 feet. This is 10 feet now for that insertion point. Or I could change it to 8 feet. Notice how the valve jumps now to 8 feet to that insertion point. I can also tab over to the other dynamic dimension and enter a value there if I wanted. Here I'll end up putting my valve at 7 foot 6 from the midpoint of the T and rotating the valve down to place the hand wheel horizontally. That was a quick look at precise part placement of a valve in an existing line. Now we'll move on to inserting piping components while routing. You can place piping components while routing without using the tool palette. Here's how you do it. First, I'll route some new pipe using the plant add command, and at the location where I want to insert a component, I'll enter I for the insert option. This brings me a dialog box where I can select the type of component I want to add. In this case, a 6-inch flanged gate valve. I click place and notice I can drag it along my pipe, getting dynamic dimensions indicating where I've located this part. Here I'll put my valve at 7 foot 6 and rotate the valve down. Then I can continue routing pipe. Now I'll enter I again to insert another component, in this case a T. I'll pick my T, press place, and indicate how far down I want this T. In this case, 7 feet. If I want, I can specify the rotation of the T and continue routing. Let's just finish putting this T down and route a little bit more pipe. Okay, next up, adding sloped pipe. First, I'm going to route a 20-foot pipe with no slope. Doing this will help us see the sloped pipe a little bit more clearly. So I'm going to use the dynamic input to put in 20 feet. Next, I'll go to the slope panel on the home tab of the ribbon and toggle the slope. I'll enter 1 in the slope rise box and set the run to 20. This sets the slope value at 3 degrees. Now I'll route another piece of pipe. Notice how I get a slope indication in my routing, and this pipe routes down at 3 degrees. Okay, Now I'm going to continue and try and route a vertical line from the end of this pipe. Notice I still have the slope on, so if I were to try to route up at this point, it would give me a true 90 degrees, and so my vertical pipe would also be sloped a bit at 3 degrees. I really don't want that. I really want my pipe to go directly vertical. So what I need to do is go back to my slope ribbon and click off the slope button so slope's no longer being applied. And again, now when I route vertically, I get true 90 degrees. I'll route a couple more vertical routes of pipe. Again, coming off the middle, I get a T that allows me to connect directly into that completely horizontal pipe I have above. Here, let me draw some more lines. I'm going to branch out now and do a reducing branch, again, for a vertical drains. If I change the size, it'll apply a reducer or a T, depending on my branch table, to putting this pipe directly 90 degrees or directly down. All right, that was some of the new features we have here in Plant 3D 2011. I'll hope you tune in for more videos where we show you how to route and edit pipe, produce ISOs, and complete other design tasks. Thanks for watching.